ओम गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन् उतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर सीइंग द सेम श्लोक, दट इज 21st श्लोक। वेदाविनाशिनं नित्यं ये एनमजमव्ययं कथं स पुरुषः पार्थ कं घातयति हन्तिकं। द बेसिक थीम इन दट श्लोक इज दट आत्मा इज अविक्रिया। Why is it avikriya? Because it is niravayavi. Because it has no avayavas, because it is all pervading, all encompassing, it is a niravayavi. And so there is no action in that, it is an avikriya. So that is the basic theme in that. So we were seeing the one or two purvapakshas, one or two objections by the purvapakshi. That is, one objection was, this sort of atmajnanam will not arise in anybody's mind. This is something which is impossible, you are only faking it, this is all a fake experience you are saying. So for that Shankaracharya very adequately explained, no, you are getting the knowledge of dharma, you are getting what is right and wrong. Dharma means what is right and what is wrong. You are also having an idea of what is heaven, what is God, and then what will happen to you after you die and what not. All those things, dharma, dharma, astitva, vijnanam, and also the other world, the knowledge of the other world, all these things, you are accepting all that on the strength of Veda. Then how can you dispute what that which is being experienced? There are so many people who are having that experience. Anubhava has to be acknowledged. So that is what he said. Then he also, the Purvapakshi again said, it is Karana Agocharatvat. Karana Agocharatvat means it is not perceivable by the senses. Karana is antahkarana, is also a karana, that is a mind, the buddhi. It is not something which can be comprehended by buddhi. That is what he said. Then he said, Shankaracharya answers, no, one type of mind may be incompetent, but another type of mind, what is that? Shastracharyopadesha janita, something he said. Shastracharyopadesha janita, shama damadi samskrutam manaha. Atmadarshane karanam, something like that he said. Shamadamadi samskrutam manaha, that is manaha which has been samskrutam, which has been purified, which has been all the impurities of the mind, that is the raga, dvesha, and the feeling of limitedness, and all these things have been driven away. So for such a mind, it is not difficult or something which is inconceivable. Atmajnana is not inconceivable for such a susamskrutam manaha, shamadamadi susamskrutam manaha. So he says, so one type of mind, the impure mind like an impure mirror may not be able to get the image, but a pure, just as a pure mirror can get an image, a pure mind also can get a knowledge, the knowledge of Brahma. So that is where we stop there. शास्त्राचार्योपदेशजनित शमदमादि संस्कृतं मनः आत्मदर्शने करणं या तथाच तदधिगमाय अनुमान आगमे च सति ज्ञानं नोत्पद्यते इति साहसमात्रमेतत्। ओके, देन व्हाट इज इट? For knowing this Atmajnana, you have got two pramanas. Pramana, I think I explained earlier, pramana is a means of valid knowledge. Prama is valid knowledge. Pramana is the tool or means, instrument for valid knowledge. Pramayaha karanam pramana. So what are these pramanas? Vedantins accept six pramanas, I also said. Pratyaksha, anumana, agama, upamana, anupalabdhi, and something like that. Then here for this Brahma Darshana, Atma Darshana, there are two things which he is saying. That is, number one, in addition to that experience, he is saying Anumana Agamecha Sati. Anumana Pramanam is there. Anumana, I explained to you, that is inference. I see some smoke somewhere and I infer that where there is a smoke, there is fire. So that is the inference. So what is the anumana for the sake of Brahma's say this atmagyana? This anumana, this thing is anumana is atma is immutable. This atma is something which is immutable, and the reason is because it is niravayavi. Niravayavi means because it is all pervading. It has no limbs. It is all pervading. Atma is immutable. That is the statement. Reason is because it is niravayavi. So this is the anumana. And in any anumana, there is a drushtanta which is given. Drushtanta means an example. In all other examples, there can be an example. But here, atma is the only example. There is no niravayavi thing any elsewhere. Apart from atma, there is nothing else. So in place of like atma, you can't give any similar example. So that is why there is no drushtanta in this case. So he gives a vyatireka drushtanta. Vyatireka drushtanta is say the contrary example. That is, atma is a niravayava, unlike this pen. Vyatirekena ghata divat. That is what one commentator writes. What is this? Atma avikriyaha niravayavatvat vyatirekena ghatadivat. It is not in the Bhashyam. It is written by one commentator called Bellamkonda Ramarayakavi. He has again written a very elaborate commentary on Shankaracharya's Bhashyam. And that is again supposed to be a very, very good commentary. Because he explains some small, small things. What is this anumana? You may not find in some books. But then he is a very, very student-friendly commentator. This Bellamkonda Ramarayakavi is a very student-friendly commentator. He gives every meaning. So here he said, niravayavatvat vyatirekena ghatadivat. It is called a vyatireka drushtanta. In logic, there is what is called an anumana vakyam. Anumana vakyam is, in English we say syllogism. For syllogism, if you take a book of logic, they say, all men are mortal. Socrates is mortal. Socrates is a man. Therefore, Socrates is a mortal. So that is a standard thing. Like we always say ghata ghata. They always give the example of Socrates. All men are mortal. Socrates is a man. So Socrates is mortal. So there is a pratignya. There is a statement. There is a hetu. There is a reason given. And then there is a conclusion. There is a deduction. That is, Socrates also is a mortal. So that is the drushtanta. It is called anumana vakyam. So here, for this anumana, the only example is atma. Atma is avikriya because it is niravayavi. There is no other example. Atma is the only example. So it is a counter example is given, unlike the pen. Vyatirekena ghatadivat. So that is what that Ramarayakavi says. So anyway, so tad adhigamaya anumane agamecha sati. Agama is shastra. Shastra, of course, any number of quotations are there that it is beyond the senses, and then it cannot be perceived by the senses. Any number of quotations are there. Agamecha sati, while these things are existing, while this anumana is existing, and then while agama, this shastra pramana is also existing, jnanam na utpadyate iti sahasamatra metat. If you say that such a knowledge does not arise, it is a very, very hasty statement. Sahasam means, in Telugu we say sahasam means adventure. But here sahasam does not mean adventure. The word sahasa means hasty, something which is hasty, something which is not properly thought of, an impertinent statement. So that is the meaning of here. Sahasametat. Sahasamatrametat. I can only say that your statement is highly impudent or impertinent. Next line. Jnanam cha utpadyamanam.
Jnanam cha utpadyamanam.
Tad viparitam ajnanam. Avashyam badhata. Iti abhyupagantavyam. Tachya ajnanam darshitam.
Hantaham.
Hatosmi.
Iti.
Ubhautau na vijanita iti. Okay. Jnanam cha utpadyamanam tad viparitam ajnanam avashyam badhate iti abhyupagantavyam. So by what all we discussed earlier, we have to necessarily agree that jnanam will arise एंड देन दट ज्ञानम विल नेगेट ज्ञानम च उत्पद्यमानम तद्विपरीतम अज्ञानम अवश्यम बाधते दट मीन्स ज्ञानम इज अराइजिंग एंड वेन यू लाइट अ लैम्प व्हाट डज इट डू ऑटोमेटिकली यू नीड नॉट से दट डार्कनेस गोज अवे यू नीड नॉट से द मोमेंट यू लाइट अ लैम्प डार्कनेस गोज अवे सो लाइक दैट ज्ञानम उत्पद्यमानम दट तद्विपरीतम अज्ञानम द समथिंग विच इज कॉन्ट्ररी टू दट व्हाट इज दट कॉन्ट्ररी टू दट अज्ञानम That avashyam badhate, it is driven off, it is dispelled, it is negated. So that is the meaning here. Jnanam cha utpadyamanam, that is that which is arising, utpadyamanam. Tadviparitam ajnanam, tadviparitam is something which is opposite to that. Viparitam is opposite, contrary. Something that tadviparitam ajnanam avashyam badhate, it definitely dispels, it definitely drives off. Iti abhyupagantavyam, abhyupagama means accept. You have to concede, you have to accept abhyupagantavyam tach because for what? It is something which is experienced. It is something which is experienced by all these jnanis. Tach ajnanam darshitam and that ajnanam also, what type of ajnana is that? Hantaham. That is, I am the slayer, I am the person who is killing. Killing of course is only an example, it applies to all actions. I am the doer. Hatosmi, I have been killed. I am either the doer or the karma for doership. Somebody else is doing and I am receiving the fruit of that karma. So that is, that means that I am the object of that karma, object of that action. So hantaham hatosmi iti ubhau tau na vijanitaha. Both these people are unenlightened. Na vijanita means unenlightened. Na vijanita means unenlightened iti.
Atracha
atmanaha hananakriyayah kartrutvam
कर्मत्वं
हेतुकर्तृत्वं च
अज्ञानकृतं दर्शितम्
ओके हियर दिस टाइप ऑफ डूयरशिप समबडी हू इज अ डूयर समबडी हू इज कॉजिंग समबडी एल्स टू डू दैट इज अ कॉजल से एजेंट वी कैन से एजेंट एंड कॉजल एजेंट दैट इज व्हाट सम पीपल हैव सेड कर्तृत्वं दैट इज डूयरशिप समथिंग बीइंग अ डूयर Then karmatvam, being the recipient of that action, something I am giving a pen to you, I am the karta and you are the receiver, who you are the karma, karmatvam, then karmatvam is there in you, suppose I give this pen to you, kartrutvam is in me, I am the karta, I am doing something, you are receiving it, you are the doer, so karmatvam is in you. So kartrutvam and karmatvam, hetu kartrutvam, I ask you to give this pen to the other gentleman, so I am the hetu karta. For transferring this pen to somebody else. I am the Hetukarta. You are the main Karta. I am the Hetukarta. So like that. So Kartrutvam, Karmatvam, Hetukartrutvam, all these things are Ajnana Kurtam. They are all because of Ajnana. You have visualized one sort of Pramata. And in the last class or prior to that, we also saw that who is the Brahmajnana? Who is the chap who is getting this Jnanam? Then we also saw one line that Antahkarana Vachinnam Chaitanyam. Ajnana kalpitam pramata. That is, what is that? It is not in this thing. We saw in some other bhashyam, not in Shankaracharya's bhashyam, but in some other notes, some other commentary. What is this? Antahkarana avachinnam chaitanyam jivaha. That is the chaitanyam or consciousness which is delimited by antahkarana, which is confined to this antahkarana. This is called jiva. And then you are attributing the jiva qualities on the chaitanyam. So that is the picture. And then that ajnana kalpitam, that thing also, that pramata, that knowership, all this thing is in the realm of ajnana, ajnana kalpitam. So kartrutvam, hetu kartrutvam cha ajnana krutam darshitam. Darshitam means it has been shown. It has been shown. Tatcha sarva kriyasvapi samanam.
Sarva kriyasvapi samanam.
Kartrutvadehe.
Kartrutvadehe.
Avidya krutatvam.
Avidya krutatvam.
Avikriyatvad atmanaha. Okay, he is also giving the reason. Tacha sarva kriyasvapi samanam. In fact, Shankaracharya, for our benefit, he is repeatedly saying that this so-called kriya, anana kriya, it is only given as an upalakshanam. It is given as an example. There is a word called upalakshanam. There is an interesting example for that. What is it? Suppose in olden days we used to dry certain things in the sun. Suppose you prepare some what is called odiyalu or something and then you dry them in the sun. And then You say, you tell a small child is, a small boy is there who is just guarding it. Say, okay, you say you guard it from crows which may come and eat away those odiyalu. Odiyalu, I do not know what is there in English, prions, let us say. So let us say, you tell that boy, you see that crows don't come and eat away. Then suppose this boy thinks, okay, crow, when the crow comes, he drives it away. But when a cat comes and eats it, he keeps quiet. So when you say crow, it also applies to a cat. It also applies to any other animal which can come and eat away those phryams. So that is a kaki, kakebhyo dadhi rakshatam. That is the sentence. Kakebhyo dadhi rakshatam means let the curd be protected from this kaki, that is crow. It may be something else, it may be dadhi, it may be some other eatable which can be taken away by any other rat, cat, any other animal. So which means if you say it protected from rat, you have to protect it from cat, you have to protect it from all other things. So this karma here, it is an upalakshanam. Hanana kriya is an upalakshanam for all other karmas. So Shankaracharya is repeatedly saying so that people like in Russia, what they did, somebody will say, Bhagavad Gita is a book which is repeatedly telling about killing. So all our standard conventional interpretations, it is not an interpretation keeping in mind the 21st century people. It is a conventional interpretation only in this context, because Arjuna is prepared for a war. He is there in the battlefield. That example is given. And Rigveda, some other example, the same example is given, not because they want to kill and what not. Rigveda doesn't talk about killing. It is given because it is a strong example. When you give a strong example, it applies to all other actions. So that is the basic meaning. So, tachya sarva kriya svapi samanam kartrutvadehe avidya krutatvam. Kartrutvadehe avidya krutatvam. All this kartrutva, karmatva, hetu kartrutva we talked about. Kartrutva is direct doership. Karmatva is being the karma, then hetu karta means causing somebody else to do. All these things are avidya kritam, because you are confining or you are thinking that you are a particular deha. When you think that you are a particular deha, you also see the other man as a deha. When you feel that you are a delimited, confined person, confined with a body, intellect and what not, you also see the other man, say, okay, so and so height, so and so weight and what not. So you look at it from that point of view, from that point only. But an Atmajnani doesn't look like that. For an Atmajnani, when he realizes that he is not the body, he does not see the other man as a body. He sees it as Atma only. He sees it as Atma only. So that is why all these things are in the realm of avidya. This hetu kartrutvam kartrutvadehe avidya kartrutvam. Avikriyatvad Atmanaha. He also gives the reason. Atma is avikriya. For that reason, there is no kartrutva. That sentence he is repeating only to drive home the point. Next line. Vikriyavan hi karta.
Vikriyavan hi karta.
Atmanaha karma bhutam.
Atmanaha karma bhutam.
Anyam prayojayati kuru iti.
Anyam prayojayati kuru iti.
Yes. So, a vikriyavan. That is somebody who undergoes a change. Who is that? Only one who thinks that he is an incomplete man. One who thinks that he is a confined being. One who is a limited, delimited being. Only he has some action. But when he feels that he is a Purna, tomorrow we are going to see that Purnamadah Purnamidam Shloka and that Ishavasya. So in that Purnamadah Purnamidam, that is Purnam, this is Purnam. That is complete, this is complete. So this, whatever I call it as me, as I, this is also complete. So that is what we have to realize there. That infinite is there, that fullness is there in Brahman, the fullness is there in me also. So that is the meaning. So when you realize that this is all Purna, this is all full, then you will not feel that there is some action. So Vikriyavan hi Purushaha, Vikriyavan hi. He means Yasmat, because of this. This he is an avyaya, vikriyavan he is an avyaya, which means because of that, vikriyavan he karma atmanah karma bhutam anyam prayojayati. Atmanah karma bhutam. I am a vikriyavan, I am an unenlightened person, then I will ask you to give this pen to somebody, so you become a karma. So I am also ignorant, I feel that you are also ignorant, and then I direct you to do something else. सो विक्रियावान् हि पुरुषः कर्ता आत्मनः कर्मभूतम् अन्यम् आत्मनः कर्मभूतम् मीन्स् समबडी हू बिकम्स् ए कर्म टू हिम् दट् ईस् वेन् ऐ एम् गिविङ्ग् दिस् पेन् टु यू यू बिकम् ए कर्म टु मी आत्मनः कर्मभूतम् समबडी हू बिकम्स् ए कर्म टु हिम् वाट् डस् ई डू कर्म आत्मनः कर्मभूतम् अन्यम् प्रयोजयति कुरु इति प्रयोजयति मीन्स् डैरेक्ट्स् हि डैरेक्ट्स् हिम् वैस् वाट् कुरु इति डू दिस् नेक्स्ट लाइन तदेतत् अविशेषेण विदुषः सर्वक्रियासु कर्तृत्वं हेतुकर्तृत्वं च प्रतिषेधति भगवान् कर्मादि विदुषः कर्माधिकाराभाव प्रदर्शनार्थं वेदाविनाशिनं कथं स पुरुषः इत्यादिना या ओके अगेन ही इज सेइंग तत् एतत् एंड दिस पॉइंट तद् एतत् ऑन दिस सेम पॉइंट अविशेषेण अविशेषण मीन्स विदाउट एनी एक्सेप्शन अविशेषेण विदुषः सर्वक्रियासु फॉर ए ज्ञानी फॉर एन आत्मज्ञानी इन ऑल हिज एक्शंस विदाउट एनी एक्सेप्शन लॉर्ड कृष्णा इज सेइंग इज आर रादर ही इज नेगेटिंग कर्तृत्वं हेतुकर्तृत्वं आल दीज थिंग्स आर नेगेटेड फॉर एन एनलाइटेड मैन सो दिस सेंटेंस इज तद् एतत् द सेम पॉइंट अविशेषेण मीन्स नॉट ओनली फॉर हनन क्रिया नॉट ओनली फॉर द एक्ट ऑफ स्लेइंग बट फॉर ऑल अदर एक्ट्स सर्व क्रियासु विदुषः फॉर एनलाइटेड मैन कर्तृत्वं दैट इज बीइंग द एक्टर हेतुकर्तृत्वं बीइंग द डायरेक्टर ही इज नाइदर द एक्टर नॉर द डायरेक्टर ओके दिस इज अ सिंपलर वर्ड एक्टर एंड डायरेक्टर कर्तृत्वम् अंड हेतुकर्तृत्वम् च प्रतिषेधति भगवान् भगवान् ही इज प्रोहिबिटिंग बोथ दीज थिंग्स इन ए होम इन एन एनलाइटेड मैन विदुषः कर्माधिकाराभाव प्रदर्शनार्थम् कर्माधिकार अभाव कर्माधिकार इज देयर फॉर होम कर्माधिकार मीन्स एन ऑब्लिगेशन टू डू ए कर्म एन ऑब्लिगेशन टू डू ए कर्म इज देयर फॉर एन अविद्वान् एन अविद्वान् ही शुड नॉट कीप क्वाइट आल्सो बिकॉज वी हैव बीन सीइंग इन दिस वैदिक स्कीम ऑफ थिंग्स मैन ग्रेजुअली ग्रोस फ्रॉम स्टेप बाय स्टेप इनिशियली इफ यू लीव ए मैन एज टू हिमसेल्फ ही विल डू ऑल एरेटिक डीड्स सो द वेदा प्रिस्क्राइब्स सम कर्मास एंड देन ही इट आल्सो टेल्स इनिशियली ही डज इट फॉर स्वार्थम दैट इज फॉर सेल्फिशनेस एंड अगेन वेदा टेल्स नो नो काइंडली गेट रिड ऑफ यूर स्वार्थ यू डू इट एज एन ऑर्डर फ्रॉम द लॉर्ड So, Ishwararpana Buddhi, that is the second stage, that is Karma Yoga. And from the next stage, it says, you are a Brahma yourself, there is no action in you, there is no Kartrutva, no Bhoktrutva. So, that is the stage. What is this line? Vidushah Karmadhikara Bhava Pradarshanartham. In order to demonstrate that for a Vidwan, for an enlightened man, there is no obligation for karma. There is an obligation for karma in the case of an avidwan, in the case of a karmata, a person who is a mimamsaka. A person who is a mimamsaka, there is an obligation because he doesn't believe in jnana and whatnot. He doesn't believe in Brahman. He only believes in some heaven and he believes in all these heavenly pleasures and whatnot. So that is the picture. Karmadhikara bhava pradarshanartham veda avinashinam nityam. This is the same sentence, the same shloka which we are seeing. कथम स पुरुष पार्थकम घातयति द सेम श्लोक बाय सेइंग ऑल दीज थिंग्स ही इज रिपीटेडली डेमोन्स्ट्रेटिंग दैट देर इज नो कर्तृत्व सो नेक्स्ट लाइन क्व पुनः विदुषः अधिकारः इत्येतदुक्तं पूर्वमेव ज्ञानयोगेन सांख्यानां इति ओके क्व पुनः विदुषः अधिकारः यू आर सेइंग दैट ऑल दिस कर्म इट इज एंजॉइंड ऑन एन अविद्वान दिस कर्माधिकार आर दिस ऑब्लिगेशन टू डू कर्म इज ओनली फॉर एन अविद्वान क्व पुनः वेर देन क्व पुनः मीन्स वेर देन क्व इज वेर या क्व पुनः वेर अगेन पुनः मीन्स अगेन वेर अगेन वेर आर देर विच मीन्स इन इंग्लिश यू कैन इडियोमेटिकली से वेर देन Do you say that the Vidwan has an adhikara? In what is his obligation? Vidwan, what is the obligation for him? Ityeta duktam purvam eva. It has been said, what? Jnana yogena sankhyanam, karma yogena yoginam. He told in the commentary, of course, he told this in the commentary, this shloka is going to come again in the third, say, adhyaya. Pura dvenishte, pura dvividhanishta, pura proktamayanaka, jnana yogena sankhyanam, karma yogena yoginam. That shloka we are going to see in the third shloka, but he has already mentioned it in the commentary. So that is why he is saying, purvameva uktam, it has been said, it has been already discussed, he is saying. Jnana yogena sankhyanam iti. Tathacha, सर्वकर्मसन्यासं वक्ष्यति
सर्वकर्माणि मनसा इत्यादिना
तथा च मीन्स लाइक वाइज सर्वकर्मसन्यासमपि वक्ष्यति ही आल्सो सेज सर्वकर्मसन्यासं ऑल दैट इज रेनन्सिएशन ऑफ ऑल एक्शन दैट हैज बीन टोल्ड फॉर अ ज्ञानी नॉट फॉर ऑल पीपल ही इज टॉकिंग वी आर नाउ इन द प्रकरण वी आर नाउ इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ सांख्य Sankhya is samyak jnanam. We are in the context of knowing the actual nature of the jiva. The actual nature of the jiva is that of the Brahman itself. So then we are in that prakarana. So for one who knows this actual nature or the real nature is a Sankhya or a jnani or a vidwan. We are in that context. This sarvakarma sannyasa is for that gentleman, not for the other avidwan. Avidwan, he has to jolly well do his job. ओके तथा च लाइक वाइज सर्वकर्म संन्यासं वक्ष्यति सर्वकर्माणि मनसा इत्यादिना दिस सर्वकर्माणि मनसा संन्यस्यास्ते सुखं वशी दिस इज एक्चुअली देयर इज अ डिस्कशन ऑन दैट श्लोक दिस इज अ श्लोक फ्रॉम फिफ्थ अध्याय यू कैन एक्चुअली सी दैट टेक्स्ट आल्सो फिफ्थ अध्याय दैट थर्टींथ श्लोक फिफ्थ अध्याय सर्वकर्माणि मनसा संन्यस्यास्ते सुखं वशी नवद्वारे पुरे देहि नैव कुर्वन् न कारयन् So that shloka word by word, we are now going to see in this commentary because that all this forms a sort of introduction. In fact, this is all Sankhyam only. In fact, in that fifth adhyaya again, a few shlokas are devoted to Sankhya. A few shlokas, starting from that 5-13, that is, what is this shloka? Sarvakarmani manasa sanyasyaste sukham vashi navadvare pure dehi naiva kuron nakare that we are going to discuss sarvakarmani manasa means all actions by thought sanyasya is also there sarvakarmani manasa sanyasya means renouncing all actions mentally means what does it mean that is by knowing the real nature of it by viveka buddhi By proper discrimination, nitya anitya vastu viveka, by proper discrimination of what is right and what is wrong, what is eternal and what is non-eternal. So by that discrimination, by viveka buddhi, you are discarding all these things. That is manasa sanyasya. Manasa sanyasya means that. It is not simple vividisha sanyasa. Vividisha sanyasa I told in the last class, somebody who is desirous of knowing and then he is in that path. But this is a vidvat sannyasi. He knows the reality. So, sarva karmani manasa ityadina. Okay. Now, here is a small puropaksha. Let us read. Nanu.
Nanu.
Manaseti vachanat. Vachi, na vachikanam kaikanam cha sannyasaha.
Na vachikanam. It's not there.
It should be there. Sarva karmani manasa ityadina. Just see. Sarva karmani manasa ityadina. ननु मनसा इति वचनात् न वाचिकानां कायिकानां च संन्यासः इति चेत् न सर्वकर्माणि इति विशेषितत्वात् सो हियर् दिस् पूर्वपक्षी इस् सेयिङ्ग् मनसा ही इस् सेयिङ्ग् मनसा इति वचनात् सो यु आर् सेयिङ्ग् इन् दट् श्लोक ऐ थिङ्क् यु केन् हेव् अ लुक् अट् दट् श्लोक आल्सो इफ् यु सी दट् श्लोक I will first explain that shloka so that this meaning becomes easy. 5-13, you please take out. You got it? Fine. So that shloka says, Sarva karmani manasa sanyasya aste sukham vasi. That is the first line. Sarva karmani manasa sanyasya having renounced सुखम नो सर्वकर्माणि मनसा सन्यस्य आस्ते आस्ते मीन्स ही स्टेस आस्ते स्टेस सेम एज अस्ति आस्ते सुखम वशी ही स्टेस सुखम मीन्स हैप्पीली दट इज ब्लिस ब्लिस बिकॉज ऑफ अवेयरनेस नॉट समथिंग नॉट अ सुखम बिकॉज ऑफ अक्वायरिंग समथिंग नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ अक्वायरिंग सम मटेरियल प्रोडक्ट बट बिकॉज ऑफ अक्वायरिंग नॉलेज बिकॉज ऑफ दट एनलाइटनमेंट ही इज हैप्पी ही इज कंटेंटेड वशी वशी वन हू इज हैविंग कंट्रोल ऑफ हिज सेल्फ कंट्रोल वशी मीन्स वन हू हैज कंट्रोल ऑन हिज ओन सेल्फ वशी देन नवद्वारे पुरे देही देही मीन्स जीवा देह हास्य अस्ति इति देही The person who, the chap who is dwelling in this deha, that is dehi, not the linga sharira. We are referring to jiva. Where is he dwelling? In this city with 9 gates, Navadvare Pure. In fact, the human body is referred to as Navadvara Pura. In Telugu, in all types of songs, folk songs also, we find this thing. This is a small bag of skin, flesh and bones with 9 gates, 9 doors to it and things like that. There are some folk songs also there you might be knowing. So, Navadvare Pure Dehi Naiva Kurvan Nakarayan. That means, he does not do anything and he is not the director for anything. He is not doing, he is not the actor nor the director because he has By proper understanding, manasa means by proper understanding, he has renounced all the actions. So that is the meaning of the shloka. Sarva karmani manasa sanyasya aste sukham vashi navadvare pure dehi. And then having renounced, he has not gone anywhere. He is staying. He is very much there. Even karma may be there. Karma may be there, but kartrutva is not there. There may be karma like King Janaka or like Lord Krishna himself. There is karma in Lord Krishna, but then he is not a karta. The kartutva is not there. Kriya may be there. Kriya, the existence of a kriya does not mean that there is a kartutva. So kriya may be there, but kartutva is not there. So that is why it is said, sanyasya, manasa sanyasya, aste, he exists in the body. So this is the meaning. So now that you know this shloka, you can go back to this bhashyam so that this word by word, the Purvapakshi is trying to demolish. So that is the problem. So, Nanu Manasa Iti Vachanat, yeah, we read this line. Nanu Manasa Iti Vachanat, Vachikanam, Kaikanam, Cha Sanyasa Iti Chet, Na. So, he says, okay, this Karmata is so fascinated or so addicted to karma that he doesn't want to give up karma at any cost. He doesn't want to give up karma at any cost, so he wants to do it only. So that is why he says, okay, Lord is saying, Sarva Karmani Manasa Sanyasya, you mentally renounce, okay, mentally you please renounce, but physically you do. Vachika Kaika, there is a word in Sanskrit you must be knowing, Trikarana Shuddhi. Trikarana, this is three types of karanas, three types of tools. What is it? For any action, there are three tools. That is manasika, vachika, kayika. This vachika, strictly speaking, it need not be there. I can think something and then I can straight away do. I need not tell also. But then somehow this trikarana is mentioned. Somehow that has become a convention. There is nothing very, very sacrosanct about it. Trikarana suddhi. That is by mind, word and deed, we can say. By thought, word and deed, we can say. So this thought, mentally, You are saying sanyasya, manasa sanyasya, okay, mentally you do whatever you want, but let us physically do, that is what he says. Nanu, manasa iti vachanat, because it has been said, vachanat means because it has been said, vachanam is there, so that is why, vachanat means because of that word, because it has been said, what, nanu manasa. Sanyasya iti vachanat, na vachikanam kaikanam cha sanyasaha. All these things, actions by words and deeds need not be renounced. Let us do our yajna, let us do our yaga, let us do all these things. Manasa, sanyasya, whatever you want to do, you do. So he wants to be a stickler to that. Then the reply is, na, sarva karmani iti visheshi tattvat. It has been exclusively or specifically mentioned. A visheshanam is there. Sarva is a visheshanam. Sarva karmani. Karmani is the plural, karmas, that is karmani. Sarva is the visheshanam for karmani. सो सर्वकर्माणि इति विशेषितत्वात् मीन्स् विशेषणं कॉल्ड सर्व इज एडेड टू दैट दैट इज द मीनिंग सर्वकर्माणि इज एक्सक्लू ई मीन इट हैज बीन एक्सप्रेसली सेड और स्पेसिफिकली सेड दैट सर्व सर्वकर्माणि सो नेक्स्ट लाइन मानसानामेव
मानसानामेव
सर्वकर्माणि इति चेत्
सर्वकर्माणि इति
न मनोरूपकत्वात् वाक्कायव्यापाराणां मनोव्यापाराभावे तदनुपपत्तेः ओके ही सेज द पूर्वपक्षी अगेन सेज मानसानामेव सर्वकर्माणि ओके ऑल एक्शंस ओनली बाय मेंटली ओनली बाय माइंड यू रिनाउंस That is what he says. All actions only by mind you renounce. Then the Siddhanti says, "No, it is not so. Manovyapara purvakatvat vakkaya vyaparanam. Manovyapara should always be there. It should pre-exist. In fact, you have to think about something and then only you do something. For any action, suppose I want to go out somewhere. First of all, I have to get that idea. Without getting the idea, you will not go. That can only happen in some sleepwalking. It can only happen in sleepwalking where manovyapara is not there. Manovyapara means, vyapara is not like our Telugu vyapara. Vyapara is not business. Vyapara means activity. Vyapriyate. The mind is engaged in that. It gets into that. So that is vyapara means mental activity. Manovyapara purvakatvat vakkaya vyaparanam. If you want this, for any action to take place, there should be a thought in the mind. That thought is a manovyapara. It is an activity in the mind. So the activity in the mind should precede any other activity, either word or deed. So that is the meaning here. Manovyapara purvakatvat vakkaya vyaparanam manovyapara abhave tad anupapattehe. Unless it is something which is conceived by the mind, unless that manovyapara takes place, this physical vyapara, this physical activity will not take place. So that is it. Next, this Purvapakshi again he is hitting, trying to say, Shastriyanam, Vakkayakarmanam, Karanani, Manasani Varjayitva, Anyani, Sarvakarmani, Manasasanyaset, Iti Chet, Na. नैव कुर्वन् नकारयन् इति विशेषणात् सो ही इज अगेन गोइंग बैक टू द सेम श्लोक शास्त्रीयाणां वाक्काय कर्मणां कारणानि मानसानि वर्जयित्वा ओके ही सेज यू रिटेन द मेंटल से एक्टिविटी फॉर शास्त्रीय कर्मास यू रिटेन द मेंटल एक्टिविटी फॉर शास्त्रीय कर्मास देन यू रिजेक्ट ऑल अदर थिंग्स शास्त्रीयाणि कर्माणि for all this Shastriya karmas, what has been enjoined, what have been recommended, or so there are some karmas which have been recommended, there are Nishiddha karmas, prohibited karmas. For all these recommended karmas, they are called Shastriya karmas. So for all that, okay, fine, you retain the mental activity also, we don't mind. But then you leave the other things. What are that? Ashastriya karmas. For all these Ashastriya karmas, you leave all that. శాస్త్రీయాణం వాక్కాయ కర్మణం కారణాన్ని మానసాన్ని వర్జయిత్వా దట్ ఈజ్ ఫర్ యు ఆర్ సెయింగ్ దట్ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీ యాక్టివిటీ దేర్ ఈజ్ ఎ మెంటల్ రీజన్ ద మెంటల్ ప్రాసెస్ షుడ్ ప్రిసీడ్ దట్ మెంటల్ ప్రాసెస్ షుడ్ ప్రిసీడ్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ యు ఆర్ సెయింగ్ సో ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు డూ దట్ ఓకే లెట్ దట్ మెంటల్ ప్రాసెస్ రిగార్డింగ్ ది శాస్త్రీయ కర్మాస్ దే రిమైన్ ఫర్ ఆల్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ సర్వ ఫర్ ఆల్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ శాస్త్రీయాణం వాక్కాయ కర్మణం కారణాన్ని మనసాన్ని వర్జయిత్వా అన్యాని సర్వకర్మాణి మనసా సన్యస్యే ఆల్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ యూ లీవ్ ఆల్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ సర్వకర్మాణి మనసా యూ లీవ్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ఇన్ ద కేస్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ త్రికరణ శుద్ధి ఇన్ ద కేస్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ బోత్ ఆల్ మెంటలీ బై వర్డ్ డీడ్ థాట్ యూ అప్లై టు ఆల్ బట్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ ద కేస్ ఆఫ్ శాస్త్రీయ కర్మాస్ యూ రిటైన్ దిస్ మెంటల్ థింగ్ సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ హీ సేస్ దెన్ ది పూర్వ ది సిద్ధాంతి అగైన్ సేస్ నైవ కుర్వన్ నకారయన్ దట్ ఈస్ వెన్ సంబడి హూ ఈజ్ అన్ ఎన్లైటన్డ్ మ్యాన్ వెన్ అన్ ఎన్లైటన్డ్ మ్యాన్ వెన్ హీ రినౌన్సెస్ కర్మాస్ హీ విల్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ రినౌన్స్ అశాస్త్రీయ కర్మాస్ హీ విల్ ఆల్సో రినౌన్స్ ఆల్ అదర్ కర్మాస్ It is not, it is totally almost illogical to say that an enlightened man has given up, say, Ashastriya Karma. It is rather too stupid to say. It is like saying a jnani, he has given up some silly thing like drinking or something like that. It goes without saying that a jnani leaves up Ashastriya Karmas. Then an enlightened man will renounce all karmas. He is called a jnani only because he is renouncing all karmas, not only Ashastriya Karma. So that is what this, I think, Anandagiri also, there is a line which says, Naiva Kurvan, Nahi Viveka Buddhya Sarvani Karmani Ashastriyani Sanyasya Tishtatiti Yuktam. It is rather foolish to say, it goes without saying that a Vidwan, he renounces all actions, say all Ashastriya Karmas, all unrecommended Karmas. So when you say it a Vidwan, he is renouncing all Karmas, not only Ashastriya Karmas. So that is the meaning of the line here. Shastriyanam Vakkaya Karmanam Karanani Manasani Varjayitva means with those mental processes which are the reason for this Shastriya Karma, you retain that and then you leave all others. That is what he is saying. The Siddhanti says, no, naiva kurvan nakarayan iti visheshanat. Because it has again been said, naiva kurvan nakarayan. Sarva karmani naiva kurvan nakarayan. So he says, it is totally, all things are rejected. Then there is another line, another small purvapaksha. Sarva karma sanyasaha ayam.
Sarva karma sanyasaha ayam.
Bhagavata uktaha.
Bhagavata uktaha.
Marishyataha.
Marishyataha.
Na jivata.
Na
iti chen na.
Iti chen na.
Navadvare pure dehe. Navadvare pure dehe, not dehe, dehi. Navadvare pure dehi aste.
Navadvare pure dehi aste.
Iti visheshana anupapattehe.
Iti visheshana anupapattehe.
Okay, he is again, this Mimamsakas, they have got another theory. They have got a concept called apat sanyasa. We have learnt two words called Vidvat Sanyasa and Vividisha Sanyasa. So Vidvat Sanyasa, an enlightened man, he renounces. Vividisha Sanyasa, an unenlightened man, but he has got some superficial knowledge of these things and then he wants to be on the right path. So he also gives up this Karma Sanyasa and then he is seriously studying, he is seriously doing introspection sitting with a guru. That is Vividisha Sanyasa. There is another type of sannyasa called apat sannyasa. Apat sannyasa means when a fellow is about to die, when a person is about to die, maybe in half an hour or 1 hour, he is about to die, and then at that time, because of his samskara and because it has been drilled into his mind, he is a karmi. We are now talking about a karmi only. We are not talking about an atheist. We are talking about a karmi, a person who is very much in the religion, very much doing all these yajnas, yagas and whatnot, all the while, throughout his life he has been doing karmas. So we are now talking about that person. That person again, from our point of view, he is an ajnani. So he, because he has heard, all said and done, the Veda says, okay, sannyasa is the supreme. All said and done, one who has to renounce and whatnot, it says. So at the time of death, so he feels, okay, let me now take sannyasa, maybe I will get moksha. Let me take sannyasa. So just before dying, maybe half an hour or 1 hour, then some guru is called and then that guru, sannyasa, he can't straight away take, somebody has to come and initiate him into sannyasa. So then some Swamiji has to come and then initiate him into some sannyasa, okay. Sanyastamaya, Bhus Sanyastamaya, Bhuvas Sanyastamaya, some mantras are told, either if he is capable of saying, he will say, or on behalf of him, somebody else will say, and then this fellow will say, yes, I am Sanyastam. So that is, what is the theory of Mimamsakas? Mimamsakas, from Mimamsakas point of view, Sanyasa is prescribed for physically handicapped people. They say, all physically fit people have to do karmas, all physically fit people have to do yajna, yaga and what not. This sannyasa, which all these Vedantis are talking about, they are for physically handicapped people, for deaf, dumb and all these types of people. And then for Marishyata, somebody who is going to die. So this is what, in fact, Shankaracharya ridicules in one place. I have written that sloka somewhere. Not sloka, one small line. Shankaracharya in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, in one place, in that Sharirika Brahmanam, he says, if you say that दिस सन्यासा इज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड ओनली फॉर डेफ डम लेम ऑल दिस लेम टाइप ऑफ पीपल देन इज शास्त्र प्रिस्क्राइबिंग एनी टाइप एनीथिंग लाइक हिल क्लाइंबिंग और रॉक क्लाइंबिंग टू यू ही सेज फॉर अस ओके यू से दैट सन्यासा मीन्स परिव्राजका Parivrajaka is somebody who has no place to stay, who has not that he has no place to stay, he doesn't want a place to stay. In fact, he is moving around, Paritaha Vrajati, he moves around, so he doesn't stay in a place, he is a Parivrajaka, somebody something is a sort of wandering monk, a wandering sannyasi, a wandering philosopher you can say. So, this is the type of thing which is contemplated for a Parivrajaka or a sannyasi. So, like there is something prescribed for us, Shastra also should prescribe to you some rock climbing, some hill climbing, etc. So, Vrukshadhyarohanadhyapi Parivrajyavat Kalpiyata Shastram. Shastram, this is not here in this line, it is there in that Bhashyam in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Like Shastra has prescribed some Parivrajyam to us, it will also prescribe some tree climbing, Vrukshadhyarohanam. Tree climbing, some rock climbing, hill climbing and trekking and what not. Shastra has to prescribe. Shastra has not prescribed all that to you. So which means that sannyasa is not for deaf and dumb and lame and what that type of people. Sannyasa is the supreme status which is prescribed for everybody. So that is the argument of Shankaracharya. Then in fact Shankaracharya himself, how he took up sannyasa you must be knowing. Shankaracharya when he was 8 years or we do not know, I am not very sure, 8 years or 9 years, he was requesting his mother. If you have seen the movie Shankaracharya, there is a Sanskrit movie Shankaracharya on YouTube. You please see Shankaracharya movie Sanskrit. You just see on YouTube, there is a 2 hour long movie. So that boy asks, Amba Ham Sanyasi Bhavishyami. He has to seek permission. He says, no, I want to become a sannyasi, this boy says. Then that lady keeps on saying no. Then Shankaracharya is taking bath in a river. At that time one crocodile grabs and then at that time the mother also is somewhere nearby washing clothes. So then he cries out to his mother, Mother, I am grabbed by this crocodile, I am going to die, at least now you permit me. Now permit me to take sannyasa. So then the mother says, the mother feels very sad that the boy is dying and then the boy is grabbed by a crocodile and then she says, okay, you take sannyasa. At that time it so happens that the crocodile also leaves him or somehow the boy gets out of that crocodile's jaws and then he comes out. Then this is the type of apat sannyasa. Apat sannyasa we are talking about marishyataha for a man who is dying. Then for a person who is dying, if by chance he survives, then he should not come back to normal life. He should not say, okay, now that I am fit, I will again marry and then I will come back. He should not. Once he has taken a sannyasa, he has to continue that path. So that is the picture here. So the Shankaracharya, after coming out, he goes out and then his mother also, she has to accept. She has to accept that he has to go for a sannyasa. He is destined to be a sannyasi and then she allows him. So that is the meaning here. So this Purvapaksha of this man, who is this our Mimamsaka, is that Sarvakarma Sanyasahayam Bhagavata Guptaha Marishyataha. Marishyataha means for somebody who is about to die. Marishyan is the word, Marishyata is the Shasti. Marishyataha na Jeevataha. It is not for somebody who is alive. Iti Chet na. Why is it no? Navadvare pure dehi aste iti visheshana anupapattehe. It has been very clearly told in this shloka that this gentleman, a jnani, will happily stay. Navadvare pure sukhi, sukham aste. Sanyasya aste sukham vashi. He also stays happily. Navadvare pure, in that city with 9 gates, he happily stays. So that is what this line also says. Navadvare pure dehe aste. Aste means he exists, he stays. Iti visheshana anupapattehe. So that line would not suit. If you say that sarvakarma sannyasa is only for a dying man, why is this loka saying navadvare pure aste? It will contradict that line. So which means it is not for a Marishyati, it is not for a dying man. Sannyasa is not for a dying man. Sannyasa is for a person who is fighting fit, but then who has given up his desires, who has become enlightened, and then who has realized his self. So that is the meaning here. Visheshana anupapattehe. Nahi sarvakarma sannyasena mrutasya taddehe asanam sambhavati. Yeah, just as we discussed, somebody who is about to die, some half an hour is there, and then that man, he takes up sannyasa, then dehe asanam na sambhavati. Then in the case of such a man, staying in the body, that word staying in the body will not apply. Dehe aste, it does not apply. So that is the meaning here. Nahi sarvakarma sannyasena mrutasya tad dehe asanam sambhavati. By doing this sarvakarma sannyasa, that dehe asanam, asanam means staying, asanam means dwelling. In that body, it will not be possible for him to continue to dwell in that body after doing sarvakarma sannyasa. So that is the overall meaning. So the next, this man again persists, this Mimamsaka again persists with a question. Akurvataha. अकारयतस्य देहे सन्यस्य इति संबंधः न देहे आस्ते इति चेत् न. सो दिस पूर्वपक्षी वांट्स टू से डू दिस श्लोक अन्वय इन ए स्लाइटली डिफरेंट वे. फॉर दिस श्लोक इन एवरी श्लोक देर इज एन अन्वय. अन्वय मीन्स दिस वर्ड ऑर्डर विच वर्ड joins which other word, which word joins which other word. He says, what the Siddhanti earlier said was, Navadvare Pure Dehe Aste. So he says, no, you don't do anvaya like that. So you do anvaya like Dehe Sanyasya. Sarvakarmani Dehe Sanyasya Aste. That means, all these karmas, he is depositing, he is leaving in the body. Why don't you take that meaning? So this line, you see this shloka, sarva karmani manasa sanyasya aste sukham vasi navadvare pure dehi. Having renounced all karmas, he stays in the body. That is the meaning which is, that is the standard meaning. Whereas this Purvapakshi wants to take a different meaning, saying that he leaves all karmas in the body and then stays. It is as though karmas are a baggage. Which he leaves in the body and then he stays and then goes to moksha or something like that. So that is the Purva Paksha here. Akurvataha akarayatasya, that is somebody who is not doing anything and not karayataha, not directing anybody to kill, anybody to do anything. Dehe sanyasya, that is sanyasya, the word sanyasa, the Mimamsaka is giving a different meaning. Siddhanti is giving a different meaning. This word nyasa, nyasa means keeping a thing at a place. Nyasa, the word nyasa means keeping a thing at a place. In fact, in law also it means nyasa is entrustment of property. Not nyaya, in law. I should not say nyaya. In law, nyasa means entrustment of property. I give some money to you. That is a nyasam. Or I give some property to you and ask you to keep it in safe custody. That is nyasam. So that is depositing with you. I keep some gold or cash in the bank, and then that is called a nyasam. That is an entrustment. So that is the meaning of nyasa. When this sam upasarga is added, sam plus nyasa, sam is an upasarga. Upasarga is a prefix. We can say in English it is a prefix. So when an upasarga is added, time is there. When an upasarga is there, the meaning of dhatus change. There is a standard shloka which is told in grammar. What is that? Upasargena dhatvarthaha balad anyatra niyate prahara ahara samhara vihara pariharavat. There is one dhatu called hru. Hru means harane, hruing harane, that is to take away somewhere. Harane, that is to move somewhere, to take somewhere. That hru dhatu undergoes so many changes by adding so many prefixes. That dhatu undergoes so many changes by adding so many prefixes. Upasargena dhatvartaha, the dhatu's meaning changes balad anyatra. It changes, it just moves in any direction. like prahara, prahara. When you say prahara, the same hru dhatu, prahara means giving a blow. Prahara, ahara, ahriyate iti ahara, something you take in. Ahara is something you take in, you take food, that is ahriyate. Or you collect something, that is ahriyate. Buddhya dhyahurtasya vaisa, take, collect. So that is the buddhya dhyahurtasya vaisa in the last class or so. So ahriyate, prahara, ahara, samhara, samhara means killing. Vihara, vihara means just some happy going around and then moving in a small garden, and then that is a vihara, that is sightseeing, something like a sightseeing. So like the parihara, parihara is, parihara means something like a, giving a reply or removing a person from somewhere, pariharati, just pushing out somewhere. So that all like that, the same hru dhatu undergoes so many meanings. Likewise, this is the same word sanyasya, sam plus nyasaha. The mimamsaka's meaning is nyasa means depositing. Sanyasa, you are depositing all your karmas in the body. The Siddhanti says the meaning of nyasa is not that. Meaning of nyasa, when you add this sam, it means a tyaga. Sampurvaka nyasa shabdaha tyagartha. Sampurvaka nyasa shabdaha. When you add this sam, so suffix to this, prefix. When you add this prefix to this dhatu, the meaning becomes tyaga, renouncing. It is not depositing, but renouncing. So there is a meaning, there is a change in the meaning, that is what Siddhanti says. Vedanta, in Vedanta, sannyasa means not depositing somewhere, it is renouncing. So that is what he is going to say. Nahi sarvakarma, yeah, akurvataha akarayatasya, dehe sanyasya iti sambandhaha. So this Mimamsaka wants to give a different meaning to the word sannyasa, and at the same time, different word order in that sloka. There is a word order, he wants to connect that sanyasya to dehe. Dehe sanyasya aste, he says. Not dehe aste, but dehe sanyasya. So deposit all your karmas, you leave all your baggage and then stay in the body. That is what he says. Then, iti chet na, sarvatra,
sarvatra
atmanaha,
atmanaha
avikriyatva avadharanat.
Avikriyatva avadharanat.
Did we learn dehe sambandha asti, dehe asti, chetana? Okay. Sarvatra means everywhere. Whenever you see this word sarvatra, it means both shruti and smruti. Everywhere means in both shruti, that is in all the Upanishads and also in all the smrutis. Sarvatra means everywhere. It means both in the shruti and also in the smruti. Atmanaha avikriyatva avadharanat. The avikriyatva of atma. That is the fact that atma is not a doer. There is no kartrutva in atma. It is something which has been very firmly accepted and established everywhere. Everywhere, that is in the both shruti and smruti, it is very clearly accepted that atma is an akarta. That avikriyatva is again akartrutva only. Immutability. Because it is immutable, there is no kartrutva. So it is there. Atma is avikari, it is there in every shruti, in every smruti also. 2 minutes? Okay. So that is why when it is an avikari, then it is akarta also. It is only when it is a vikari, there is a kartrutva. Then that connection, that words you have to remember. So, avikriyatva avadharana, avikriyatva avadharana. It is very, very firmly, very clearly told in all the smrutis that asanakriyayascha adhikar, asanakriyayascha adhikarana apekshatvat tad anapekshatvaccha sannyasasya. Correct. Anapekshatvaccha sannyasasya. Okay. Then he says the same thing which we discussed. If I want to keep something somewhere, I need a place. Suppose I want to deposit some goods somewhere. I need some godown. I need some storeroom in order to deposit some articles. But if I want to abandon, there I don't need a place. Suppose I want to abandon, I don't need a place. So that is what is the meaning here. For keeping all these karmas, okay, you require a body. But here the meaning is not keeping, the meaning is renouncing. So he says, where is this? Asana kriyayascha, that is for the for the kriya, for the action of asana kriya, that is for being somewhere. Asana, asa dhatu is to be somewhere, to exist. To be somewhere, asana kriya yascha adhikarana apeksha. Adhikarana means adhara. Adharo adhikaranam iti. That is the meaning, adhara. Suppose I want to keep this pen, I am keeping it in my hand. My hand is the adhara. Adhara is the support. Adhikaranam, it is also called adhikaranam. You are keeping it in my, I am keeping it in my hand. So this is nyasa, nyasta. Nyasta means it is kept here. Hasta nyasta. This hasta is the adhikaranam. Hasta is the adhikaranam. And this is what is nyasta here. What is put by way of nyasa. So asana kriya yaha adhikarana apechatvat. So if I want to keep something, I need a place. And for sannyasa, you don't require that adhikarana. You don't require any such place because you are leaving. Adhikarana, asana kriya yasya adhikarana apeksha. Apeksha means requirement. Apeksha means requirement. Tad anapekshatvacha sannyasasya. For sannyasa, there is no such requirement. Apeksha is requirement. Anapeksha is, there is no requirement. Tad anapekshatvacha sannyasasya. For sannyasa, that requirement of having a place is not there. So I think we will complete, just one more line is there. Shall we complete this line or? Sampurvastu. न्यासशब्दः त्यागार्थः न निक्षेपार्थः. So that is what we just discussed. I explained to you the root, the verb, the basic word is nyasa. When sam is added, it meaning is, it changes. Sampurvastu न्यासशब्दः. Sampurvah न्यासशब्दः. Sampurvah Nyasashabdha means this Nyasashabdha which is having sam as a prefix. That, what does it mean? It is a Tyagarthaha. It gives the meaning of Tyaga, renunciation. Na Nikshepaarthaha, not in the sense of depositing something somewhere. Tasmat, Gita Shastre, Atma Jnanavataha, Sanyase Eva Adhikaraha, Na Karmani, Iti, तत्र उपरिष्टात् आत्मज्ञान प्रकरणे दर्शयिष्यामः. ओके, दिस इज द लास्ट लाइन अंडर दिस श्लोक. तस्मात् गीता शास्त्रे, देयरफॉर इन द गीता शास्त्र फॉर द एस्टैब्लिश्ड पॉइंट इज दैट फॉर ए ज्ञानी देर आर नो कर्मास, देर इज नो ऑब्लिगेशन ऑफ एनी कर्म. ही मे बी डूइंग ए कर्म, दैट्स अ डिफरेंट थिंग. ही मे बी डूइंग ए कर्म, but then that is called jnani karma, where the fruit of the action does not come to him, and then all that is something he will be just doing like an actor. Sarva karma sanyase, no, for tasmad gita shastre atmajnanavatah, for somebody who is an atmajnani, sanyase eva adhikarah, that means his eligibility is for sanyasa, his eligibility or obligation is for sanyasa. Na karmani, it is not in karma. So that is the meaning. इति तत्र तत्र उपरिष्टात् आत्मज्ञान प्रकरणे दर्शयिष्यामः. वी विल बी डेमॉन्स्ट्रेटिंग टू यू, दर्शयिष्यामः ही इज सेइंग इन प्लूरल, वी विल बी एस्टैब्लिशिंग टू यू, वी विल बी डेमॉन्स्ट्रेटिंग टू यू इन हियर एंड देयर, वेर एवर दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ आत्मज्ञान कम्स, वी विल बी डेमॉन्स्ट्रेटिंग टू यू. सो दैट इज वेयर दिस पर्टिक्युलर श्लोक एंड्स. वी विल टेक अप दिस 22nd श्लोक इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति.